We want to sketch the region enclosed by y equals e raised to the power of 3x and y equals e raised to the power of 4x and x equals 1. Then we want to find the area of the region. So if we graph these on the coordinate plane, the graph looks like this. We should recognize that this blue function here would be e raised to the power of 4x, because notice as x increases, e to the 4x increases faster than e to the 3x. Notice on the left they intersect when x equals 0, and the right we're told x equals 1. So we're looking for the area of this shaded region here. It is important to identify which function is on top and which function is on the bottom, because when finding the area between two functions, we want to find the integral of f of x minus g of x from a to b, where f of x will be the top function and g of x will be the bottom function. So we're finding the area below the top function and above the x-axis, and then we're subtracting the area below the bottom function and above the x-axis, leaving us with the area between the two functions, where we start integrating at x equals a and stop integrating at x equals b. So looking at our graph, notice how the lower limit of integration would be 0, so a equals 0, b would be equal to 1, the upper limit of integration, and therefore the area is going to be equal to the integral of, again, the top function minus the bottom function, which should be e to the power of 4x minus e to the power of 3x integrated from 0 to 1. Let's evaluate this on the previous slide. Notice to find the antiderivative of e to the power of 4x, we'd have to perform a u substitution where u is equal to 4x, and therefore differential u is equal to 4 dx. So if we divide both sides by 4, notice that 1/4 du is equal to dx. So we integrate this, we'll have an extra factor of 1/4, which means this will be equal to 1/4 e to the 4x minus, when we integrate e to the 3x, we also have to perform a substitution. Let's call it v. So if we let v equal 3x, notice dv is equal to 3 dx, dividing both sides by 3. We have 1/3 dv equals dx. So when integrating e to the 3x, we have an extra factor of 1/3. So we have minus 1/3 e to the 3x. Now we'll evaluate this at x equals 1, and then 0, and then find the difference. So when x equals 1, we have 1/4 e to the 4th minus 1/3 e to the 3rd. And then when x is 0, we have 1/4 e to the 0 minus 1/3 e to the 0. So this would give us 1/4 e to the 4th minus 1/3 e to the 3rd. And then here we'll have minus 1/4 and then plus 1/3, since e to the 0 is equal to 1. And now to combine these fractions, our common denominator would be 12. Multiply this by 3 over 3, multiply this by 4 over 4. So we have 1/4 e to the 4th minus 1/3 e to the 3rd. This would be negative 3/12 plus 4/12 or plus 1/12. So this would be the exact area, but let's also get our decimal approximation. This is approximately 7.03769. Now in the homework though, we should enter the exact value unless it tells us to round. So going back to our graph one more time, the area of the shaded region is exactly 1/4 e to the 4th minus 1/3 e to the 3rd plus 1/12, which means the area is approximately 7.03769 square units. I hope you found this helpful.